together, so I love whenever I have to literally quiet you down because everyone's just talking and getting to know each other, and I thank you for that. We will have opportunities after class. We can go out and mingle in those chairs. That's one of the things all the collective is all about, community connection. So feel free, once we clean up our equipment, to just keep the conversations going out in the lobby. But a couple of things. Next week, I'm out of town, and so I have a sub, Kristen Pate, who has subbed before for Holy Bar, will be here next Thursday, and then I'll be back after that. So enjoy your week. I'll miss you all next week. But getting some time with my hubby, so I'll take it. So we are, for those of you that love the new faces, but for those of you that are new to Bar, one of the aspects, and if y'all want to go and stand at the edge of your mat, posture plays a big role in Bar. So a couple of things I want to talk through, and I over-communicate, like I told some of y'all whenever I leave, but I want those shoulders back, and then chest forward. We are standing tall. Lifted, head lifted, almost like you're trying to put space in that spine. And we don't lock our knee, have a slight bend, but we're still that posture of being strong and forward. But at the same time, we're going to listen to our body and the way the Lord aligned us, we're going to stick with that. And so if I'm doing something specific and you feel like your hip joint, bone on bone, then adjust to all of our hips were made slightly differently. And so I want us to listen to our body. But a big thing is, I'll talk about engage your core, which that's kind of the feeling like you're being prepared to like be punched in the gut. And so you want that tension and tightness there. I'll say belly button to the spine, all the things. I love Holy Bar. We do a series on the armor of God. And so the very first thing listed is the belt of truth, because this is where your stability is. This is where your balance is. This is where your injury prevention is. And so I want that engaged and tight. But the other aspect too is, if you think about your pelvis, your hips, we're just gonna slightly tuck, not like awkwardly tuck where it curves your back, but just a slight tuck where like your pubic bone is getting pulled up to the chest. And so as we move through it, I want to be intentional about that, because we so often, as we move through, we'll start relaxing. We'll start letting the abs relax. We'll start letting the shoulders either creep up or down. We won't go down as far because our muscles will start burning, different things. But I love, with so many parallel aspects of what we do in Holy Bar with what the Lord does in our hearts and souls, is we also naturally relax spiritually. We naturally let things slide. We naturally get comfortable. One thing that I've realized is almost like unintentionally, every night before I go to bed, I go and pray over my kids. Well, I felt like this spring, whenever they were in school and there was significant things going on in their lives and they were asking really deep questions about Jesus and God and all of this, like I was so intentional with what I prayed over them. And I caught myself, because it's summer and we're hanging out and you just lighten it, now I just go in and just say this quick little prayer and then leave. And like last night I was like, what was that? Like, come on, like let's be intentional and not drift or not relax with the summer vibe. I love summer because we get to chill and relax and all the things, but we still want to remain intentional. And so as you move through, I want that posture as well. But during the summer, Holy Bar is going through the book of Hebrews. And this week we're on Hebrews 2. And I invite you just to read Hebrews 2 slowly. We're going to savor it just like we're savoring all things summer. And so read it out loud. Read it in different translations. Read it slowly and just see if there's a word or a phrase that the Lord brings to the surface. But for me, Hebrews 2:1, the very first verse, really got my attention. And it's also for Dwell Differently. They Dwell Differently is an organization that helps with scripture memory. And they do temporary tattoos and cards and keychains and all of this. And their verse for this month is Hebrews 2:1. So I wanted to read this to y'all, and then we'll jump in. So Hebrews 2:1. We must pay the most careful attention, therefore, to what we have heard, so that we do not drift away. And the tattoos, I don't know if y'all can see, but it's like little waves. And I just think about whenever we're in a pool or on a river and we're falling asleep on a raft, we wake up in a different spot because we relax and let it slide. And so there is benefit to drifting. The Lord gave us a Sabbath. We do want to relax and rest at times, but we have to keep our focus on where we're going so we don't drift away. And so the Hebrews 2:1 just says, let's pay attention. Let's pay attention to what the Lord's doing around us and what he's doing through us. They also provided this poem. Mostly, we don't turn and bolt, we just drift. We put off for later, have so many things, get out of the habit, stare at the screen. Much more the danger to drift unaware. Rise, O sleeper, pick up your oars, recall your first love, and be restored. So let's go to him in prayer, and then we will get started. Heavenly Father, Lord, we praise you for what you're doing. Thank you for each of the beautiful souls in this room. Thank you for the opportunity to come together and move our bodies in worship, to have your breath in our lungs in and out. And Lord, we pray that during this time, you clear our minds, you calm our souls, you fill our hearts, and you strengthen our bodies. In your precious name, amen. We're going to get started, but we've also been doing the scripture flow, which is Hebrews 4:16. And so as we continue to stand at the edge of our mats, I want us to go through this. We're going to move our right leg first. We're going to start in first position, so roll those shoulders back. And you can just slightly bring that right foot forward. We have an outward rotation. But we just move through this scripture. So let us then approach the throne of grace with confidence, so that we can receive mercy, take it wide, and find grace with those heels and palms to help us in our time of need. Let's just bow those knees and lift those hands in prayer. We'll raise up again. That's Hebrews 4:16. I laugh that I'm not naturally good at memorizing scripture, but I'm kind of like a kid. You give me motion, and suddenly I know it. There's intentionality with the songs and the motions that our kids learn in Sunday school. Let's do the other leg as well, and then we'll get started. So now let us approach the throne of grace with confidence. Roll those shoulders back and give yourself a smile, so that we can receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. Woo! Let's do it, ladies, because regardless what's going on in our season, regardless the pain or the joy, the suffering or the opportunity, we get to approach the throne of grace with confidence. I want you to take a big inhale. Lower, once more. Let's step forward with that right leg. Let's give me a nice lunge. Just really stretch that left hip out. Your right knee is over that right ankle. Press into that heel. Let's slowly lift that right hand up. Give yourself a twist. Focus on your breath as you inhale and exhale. Lower it down. Let's raise our upper body, keeping our bottom half low. Lift those hands high. Spread those fingertips apart. And then open up to the Better Together wall. Roll those shoulders down. Send those arms out. We reach forward and back. That right leg and just pause right here. We're just going to let those left toes just slightly be set on the mat to keep our balance. Arms forward. Think about that core. Do a little tuck as we're here. Now have both legs join about hip distance apart. Squat it down, arms up. Now to find your balance here and to not hurt your knees, you're going to send that tailbone back. And dig into those heels. You can wiggle those toes because all your weight is back. open to the right. And reach forward and back. As you reach forward, that left knee, try to press it towards the Better Together wall. It's easy for that left knee to kind of lean forward or lean towards the inside. Up and out. So Yes. Four, three, two, take it forward, toes and arms. So that tailbone's got to go back. Four, three, two, take it up and out. Four, three, two, take it forward. Four, three, two, let's do doubles. Keep breathing right here. Four, three, two, last one. Slowly stand up. You can grab water, set your ball down, and let's grab our weight. Thank you. leg right here. Elbows in front of your ribs. Hands in line with your shoulders. Nice. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Turn them 45 degrees to the side. Think about those shoulders, that pelvis, the core. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, all the way out. Nice, come on. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. I want you to pause. Arms out, knees bent. Roll those shoulders back. Tuck that pelvis, knees towards the wall, the back wall. Hips, let's take it right. Left, right, left. Nice, slow and controlled, side to side. Use all those little muscles. Keeping your knees back, you're gonna do inner and outer thighs. Hips side to side. Get those transverse muscles as well as your obliques. Speed it up. Have some fun with it.
Thank you.
same track. Does that make sense? And let's pulse it right here. You can just hold the ball for now, or if you want a little extra arm work, press it right here. We're thinking about alignment. You can tuck that pelvis, core tight. Four, three, two, hold it low. Nice. Take that ball out. We're gonna figure eight. Think about the alignment of those knees. The figure eight just gives you a little balance challenge so your legs stay engaged. We don't want those legs to drift away. So pay attention. Four, three, two, last one. Ball in the right hand. Same combo we did with the side lunge. You tap it down and then you bring it up. Down, up. If you want, lift that right knee. We stand up through that left heel. Keep breathing, because this up and down motion with your arm is going to get that heart rate up. Go your pace. Nice. Four, three, two, last one. Let's take it back down and just press it here. Extend that left arm out. Have that right hand on that ball. We want our shin parallel to the mirror. Eight, seven, woo, six, five, four, three, two, oh yeah. Okay, let's raise up. We're gonna turn towards this wall. The ball remains in that right hand. Now we're gonna squat it down so we're all facing that blank wall. Anyway, we're all staring at you. Maybe not listening. Okay, right arm. We take it forward and your right knee moves too.
Lower back.
butt to give you a deeper move. Four. Three. Two. And raise that upper body. Now we open our center together. That's truth right there. Ball in your left hand. Sink it down. Rotate towards the mirror. I love how Hebrews 2:1, it talks about to pay attention so we don't drift away. So sometimes we just got to do what this song is. Just look what he did. Look what the Lord is doing, what he has done. And believe that he will continue to do it. Sometimes we don't see it.
Let's
gets all those nice muscles. You can keep your hands high, shoulders down and back, and just focus on your breath as you pulse.
Thank you.
Switch legs.